little bit more about how, you know, my process started, how I became, you know, what I am today. And, you know, one of the things I actually also saw you were the vice chairman, you know, that was a very motivational kind of a speech. So, I think I started my career, you know, from Telangana. I come from Telangana, from a very poor kind of a region in Telangana. I studied in Telugu medium until 12th standard. I had no introduction. We did very well, and then I went to IIT Bombay for my master's. So that, in a way, changed my entire life. Once I went to IIT Bombay, I could see the best professors. I could see the best, you know, best resources. I could come across, you know, so many bright students in the class. That changed my perspective about life. Otherwise, you know, I thought, you know, I will become some teacher somewhere, or take up some job with Wipro. In fact, I was interested in joining Wipro at one point of time. So that was how my life started. But once I went to IIT Bombay, then my perspective about life changed. And then I started to learn things and aspire for bigger things. You know, I think one of the things that I also see lacking in our current generation of students who come to IITs is they don't aim high. Now, one of the biggest problems with our students is their motivation to come to IIT is to find a job with a good pay package. Beyond that, they are not interested in anything. So that is what limits their growth, and they all become, you know, something, but they don't really do anything much beyond a few people here and there. Many of them don't really achieve much because they never aim high. That was one issue. Therefore, And after I joined IIT Bombay, then I went abroad for PhD, did everything, came back and joined IIT Bombay as a faculty member. So I was also working on doing research. I mean, I was doing research, publishing papers, everything was going quite okay. But in around 2003-2004 time frame, you know, some of us, we were all assistant professors at that time. So we said, can we do something more? I mean, all this, you know, taking a topic, publishing papers is one thing, but can we do something beyond that? Like the teachers here, you know, you have certain job profile, you need to do certain things. You can continue to do that forever, and you can graduate, and, you know, you can graduate students, and you can do the same thing for the rest of your life. But some of us at IIT Bombay said, can we do something different? So what was that we wanted to do differently? We said, can you develop products in an academic institute? Can we start to look at solving problems in the society? So that was what we wanted to do. What was the first thing we want? Is so difficult in the country right now. If you think that you have a cardiac problem, you have to go to a super speciality hospital, you have to get admitted, go through all of these tests, and then, you know, it takes almost like a day to go through all of that, then you get blood reports and all of that. Many of us don't do that because we think we are okay, and, you know, we think, you know, there is nothing wrong with us. And we know that we have a problem only when it is too late, and, you know, all of that, like what happened with Professor Ramgopal yesterday. Now, we said at IIT Bombay, can you develop a device which is in 100 rupees in 10 minutes in an MBBS clinic? Can you diagnose cardiac patients? If you have a chest pain or on your way to the college, you walk into an MBBS clinic and that person does a test, a blood test, in 10 minutes tells you your heart is okay or you are going to suffer a cardiac problem maybe in the next 6 months, you better, you know, start to take some precautions kind of thing. If somebody could advise us in 100 rupees, 10 minutes in an MBBS clinic, most of us would routinely go to these places and would get tested. You know, we can save many lives if we know that there is actually going to be a problem. So we wanted to develop such a diagnostic system at IIT Bombay. But how do I do that? I'm an electrical engineer. I was working in hardcore electronics kind of stuff. I was actually working for projects from Intel, IBM and all of that, reducing leakages in mobile phones, improving the battery life. That was my research, and which still happens to be one of my research interests as a faculty member. So once we decided to develop this cardiac diagnostic system, I'm an electrical engineer, I don't know what is cardiac problem, what causes cardiac failures, how do you diagnose. Then we went out, we said, started talking to people in the biology department, started talking to people in the biomedical department, started talking to chemists, started talking to medical doctors, and then we put a team together. The team consisted of people from 6 different departments. Until that time, IIT Bombay was not doing anything like that. Everybody takes up post library, finds a problem, does research, publishes another paper. That's how we all do research kind of thing. So then we said, you know, then we formed a team where, you know, we put people with different backgrounds together, and then we started to work on developing a platform with which you can detect these proteins in the blood. There are basically proteins like CKMB, myoglobin, troponin. If these proteins are higher in concentration, then you know that there is going to be a problem eventually. So we started to build a platform which could detect these proteins in the blood. And then we spent about 6 to 7 years in developing that platform, building a prototype, and we were able to actually conduct tests, you know, with which we could diagnose these heart related problems. But then how do you commercialize that? Being professors, how do you actually commercialize that? We filed many patents, we did all of that. Then we said, no, can we start a company? Then we went ahead, we actually started a company at IIT Bombay. We said that through this company, we will take things forward. And so that's one thing which we did. Then around that time, once we built a platform, somebody, you know, from government of India came to us and said, you know, so many people are dying because of these terrorist attacks in the country. I mean, so many explosive attacks. At that time, there were problems in Pune, the bomb blasts in Pune and elsewhere. They said, can you develop an electronic nose platform? Can you develop a platform which can replace a sniffer dog? Just as a dog would sniff explosives, can you have an electronic nose platform, a handheld system which would behave exactly like a dog and which is an electronic nose kind of a platform? And we found again the problem very interesting. And we already had a platform technology which could do that sensing. With the same technology, we started to build the prototype. We actually developed a prototype for detecting explosives in the ambient, exactly similar to a sniffer dog kind of a system. And again, we transferred this technology to a company and started looking at things. And so that's how our journey began. Then one led to other. Developing the prototype for cardiac diagnostic systems, you know, that took us almost like 10 years. Whereas the explosive detector, the prototype we could build in about 5 years. And subsequently, recently, we started working on agricultural sensors. For example, in India, agriculture is in such a bad state right now because the productivity levels are going down and agriculture is no longer very profitable. And the biggest challenge that we are facing in this country is about water, because India has only, you know, only 4% of the world's water resources and we have 18% of the world's population. And where is water used maximum? It is actually used in the agriculture. And in a place like Maharashtra, 80% of water is used by agriculture people, while only 20% goes for human consumption in cities and towns. So therefore, if 80% of water goes to agriculture, we have to save water. And agricultural scientists told us that 50% of that water is actually wasted. Farmers, since they don't pay electricity, since they think that the water is abundant, it is a resource which is abundantly available, they tend to overuse the water. In the process, a lot of water is wasted. So we were told that, can you develop a simple sensor for the farmers with which you can tell the farmer what is the optimum soil moisture that the farmer needs to maintain. Don't put more water, don't put less water. If you can have sensors to measure soil moisture, then you can advise the farmer that, no, don't, now you can save water with availability of water that you have. You can do 3 crops now instead of 2 crops. So we were given that as a problem. We again developed the prototype and then we started to transfer these technologies. We are looking at commercializing these technologies. So that is a process that we went into at IIT Bombay, you know, which started to become very interesting. And that is, but then we started to face a problem. You know, in all these cases, we make a prototype, but then to make it from a prototype to a product, you know, there is also a valley of death. You know, that is where you made two systems, three systems, but if I want to test it in the field, I need to make thousands of systems. In most of these systems, you have a high technology which you need to manufacture using a proprietary kind of a process. And there are no such technology companies in the country, and we struggled a lot, you know, trying to scale up whatever we started to develop. We went back to the government of India, said that this is a problem we are facing, and the government of India gave us about some amount of money with which we could build a prototype manufacturing facility at IIT Bombay. In an academic institute, we actually created a manufacturing facility. And we said that in this manufacturing facility, we will not allow students. We will not allow students because if you want to manufacture something, you cannot do research. You know, manufacturing has to happen with a lot of discipline, and students, you know, are not the right people to work at a place where, you know, you need to, you know, repeatedly do the same thing over and over again kind of thing. So we built such a facility at IIT Bombay, and this is a process, that is a journey. So now that is what we want to replicate. That is what institutions like yours and IITs, all of us need to be doing. One of the problems I see with all these institutions of learning in the country is we are not working closely enough with the society. And we are not looking at the society problems. We are still modeled after the North American and the Western kind of systems as far as our research is concerned. You go to any faculty member, you are given a list of papers. This is all what I have achieved. But beyond that, what have you done in terms of making a difference in society? Can all those papers add up to providing a solution to a problem that the society is facing? These are the tough questions that we have started to ask even within IITs. In fact, at IIT Delhi now one of our major themes is connecting to the society. What can we do that can address the problems of the society? At IIT Delhi, if you go to the webpage, we have launched a major program called Unnat Bharat Abhiyan. We are actually the nodal center for Government of India, the Unnat Bharat Abhiyan. Under the Unnat Bharat Abhiyan, we have written to all the IITs and we have asked them to nominate two technologies that their institutions have developed which have a relevance for the society, which have a relevance for the rural areas. So we are seeking all those technology nominations from these institutes, and in a campus that we have for IIT Delhi in Jejjar area, we are actually trying to create a full-scale model of these technologies which have relevance for the society. And once we create that exhibition of starts for these technologies or with these technologies, now we want to bring all the politicians, all the policy makers, show them what these institutions have done and see, with the help of ministries, can we replicate it in all the villages and towns and make a difference to the society. So that is what, what I believe IITs need to be doing, and all that, research, all that is fine, but at some point of time, making this high technology relevant for the society, bringing this high technology in the purview of what the society requires is what I believe is a challenge that we all need to face at some point of time, because we are all surviving on taxpayers' money. We cannot just say that producing students is our job and we don't need to be counted for anything else. And I think that change in mindset is happening now, and even Government of India is also quite keen. In fact, there is a program called Imprint Program that is known as Impacting Research, Innovation and Technology, which was launched by Government of India about 6 months ago in Rashtrapati Bhavan. They are only saying that now when you take up a project, you come up with a prototype. So far if you take a Government of India project, the output is publications. So when you publish a paper, everybody is happy that you have done something. But for the first time in this country, there is a research program where they are not looking at publications as the output. They are looking at prototypes as the output. They are saying, can you demonstrate something at the end of your project? And we received something like 2,600 proposals from various institutions in the country under the Imprint program. And we shortlisted. Now these projects are going to be funded in the next few months. So that is a change that is occurring right now. Now all academic institutions are being told, do something for the society. I think, whatever publications you do, you do that. That we are not bothered much, but I think at the end of the day, you need to show us, something that can make a difference to the quality of life, that can improve, things in the society. I think that is a big change in mindset. And at IIT Delhi, for example, we are trying to put resources together. We are trying to build groups together. One of the new things that you see at IIT Delhi, it was already in the news, was we are actually creating a department of design. Now, one of the things I faced when we were trying to do some of these activities was, as engineers, we are good at making circuits, we are good at making all these technologies, but these days the product casing is also very important. You look at the case of Apple, iPhone. What is different between iPhone and a Samsung phone? Both of them are great technologies. Both of them have inside electronics. If you see, Samsung actually outscores even iPhone as far as the technology is concerned. But why is it that people stand in a queue the whole night to buy an iPhone? The difference is the why part. What iPhone addresses is, Apple as a company, have you ever listened to, let's say, the product launches of Apple products or the product launches of Samsung? Samsung tells you a lot about what they are doing, how they are doing, but they don't focus on why they are doing. Whereas if you look at the product launch of Apple, they tell you why they are doing. At the end of the day, they say that why we are doing, we want to give that best user experience to the user. We were not interested. In fact, Apple doesn't even tell you what is the RAM capacity inside an iPhone. You don't even know what is the RAM inside an iPhone. Whereas when Samsung makes the product launch, the biggest thing is our RAM is this much, our memory is this much, and all of that. But diaper doesn't even reveal what is inside. They only tell you what is the user experience. How can the users benefit by all of that? So when you are designing a product, there are three things you look at as an engineer. One is the why aspect, one is the what aspect, one is the how aspect. The what and how are the things which many people focus, but companies like Apple focused on the why aspect. That is where the product design comes into picture. So